G'day folks, Steve from Vintage Restorations Australia here. In today's episode, we replace a broken shock absorber, replace a worn tie rod, fix a busted horn, and do a whole bunch of other little bits and pieces getting ready for registration. Once we get it through registration, I get the plates on, and then I start work on fitting out the back for camping with a swag platform, a new set of hood sticks, and a great looking hood. Before we get started with this list of little jobs we've got to do today, a quick shout out to Sean Slattery, who upgraded from a restorer level patron to a workshop manager. Thanks for your continued support, Sean. Appreciate it, mate. Just got a couple of little jobs I've got to finish for rego. Well, this isn't so little. Well, it's little, but it's major. It's I've snapped off the shock absorber here. It needs to be replaced. See the obvious problem here. This and this should be connected and they're not. Anyway, we'll pop that shocky off and replace it. There you go, I've replaced that shocky now with a patina matched shock absorber. That's a code for an old shit one that I had lying around. Job number three, replace these tie rod ends. We've got some new ones. That one doesn't look too bad. So this thing, what do you call this?
Ball joint splitter.
Ball joint splitter.
Man, this is going to be hard. You're supposed to hit both sides at the same time. And give it a good whack. There's not a lot of space there.
We've got to put a bit more tension on it first.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the problem with doing tension is that it will go...
Bang!
Yeah. Big bang.
That's all right. I don't mind a big bang done.
It's just leverage, pushing that bit down. And hopefully nothing's bending. And you can tell by that rubber boot that this will destroy what you got there.
Yeah.
So.
It's a oncer.
Yep.
And it takes, whoa, there it goes. That made me jump.
That'll shake on the camera. But yeah, it goes bang all of a sudden and that's it.
That's off.
Job done. Uh-huh. Some people just hit both sides with hammers and it looks really good if you can do it, but I can't get the timing right. So one of these guys, kind of nice, easy. Bit bent, that's life.
I'm a bit bent too, John.
This tube is threaded on the inside and this clamp squeezes the tube. Yep. If you look around somewhere, can't see it at this angle, there's a slit in this tube so that this clamp will actually bind up nice and tight. We loosen that off and then this just unscrews. It's either left or it's right-hand thread.
50-50.
50, yeah, depends which end and who put it together.
Okay.
And can be rusted in there really badly, in which case it's actually possible to shear that bolt, if you remember from a couple of episodes back.
I have seen that done.
Yeah. I was surprised, but it happens.
Oh, it's moving. How do you know if it's doing up or undoing? Might have a go the other way. Okay, I think that's the way out. Only two ways it can go. That's the other way. There we go, shiny and new. Rego ready, hopefully. So the horn here wasn't working. The switch is okay. We've taken that off and tested it. The switch is working. So somewhere along the line, this wiring is a bit dodgy. We've got power at the other end, but we're just going to pop this all out, replace it to get that going. The horn was not working, so we've salvaged one out of another car, which works. We'll pop that in. And that'll be job number five done. Just have a look at that horn to see if it's working, please, Paul.
Okay, Steve, I'll just check this horn for you, mate. Oh!
That's the worst acting I've ever seen. Can you do it again?
That was good.
This little section here, we've had to take out to put these grommets in, this one and this little one, just to stop a bit of chafing on the wires. This is all contemporary stuff. I've covered this with heat shrink here and here, and these are contemporary you know, the self-welding connectors. I quite like those. They're easy, they're idiot-proof, and I'm an idiot, so that's a good thing. I just want to put a bit of cloth tape on this to make it look a little less like that. What I've got is these two products. This is a just a hemming tape and a double-sided adhesive that you use to stick hemming tape on. You get them from your local dressmaker's shop or whatever. Go in and just ask for those and they'll have them. If you can't find the hockey tape or the original tape that went on the electrical. These were about $8 a roll, so you know, it's pretty cheap. $16 will finish these couple of little jobs up. Other little job, little clutch adjustment, just adjusting that out. Screw it out so that the clutch engages a little bit better. It was a little bit on the loose side, but it's made a big difference, just that 1 inch of adjustment there.
I've had a bit of a go at putting some solder in there, but that one leaks. This one's a lot less leaking than it used to be. I put some solder in there too, so I just have to keep going.
More solder. Unfortunately, couldn't get that heater that we bought working yet. It's still a bit leaky. John's had a red hot go at it, but every time we solder it, another leak pops up somewhere else. From what I've read and seen on the intergoogle, that's kind of a common problem with that. So we'll keep going with it, but I've just put that little plate there in the short term to cover those holes. So for registration, it's just sikaflexed on. So when we get the heater going, I can take that off, clean it up, put the heater in the holes. Just one more little job ticked off. Leather steering wheel cover on there to just get rid of the roughness. Great improvement. Just stitches on round here. Get them for about $40 off eBay. Comes from the UK. Job done. Job number 13, get a weighbridge ticket. What's it weigh?
142.
Well, doing all those little jobs paid off because it passed registration, thankfully. We only got one advice to repair the dimmer switch, or the dipper switch, I think they're called. But anyway, there's another one ordered from the UK and will be here soon. The plan for the Landy after it was registered was always to use it as my little local camping truck. So now I'm going to start fitting out the back as a sleeping platform and put the canopy on it. What I've done here is I've cut two sections of ply, one at the front and one down the back here. This is going to be hinged like that so I can access these two lockers either side. You can see I've got my little galvanised trunk up under there. That's a little bit of storage and a little bit more storage under the front. So this will hinge down and flat. You can see there it rocks a little bit on the hinges. So I'm going to cut a little rebate in the underside of the ply, just knock out 3 or 4 mils so it sits completely flat. I'll recess the hinges into that and that can just sit in there held in place by the ute tub. A couple of wheel arch rebates cut in that rear section, ready to go on. I've lined these two pieces up. I've got a bit of a piano hinge here. I'm going to fit that in, just screw it on. That hinge is on. Quick coat of paint just to seal that ply up and she's ready to go in. This is pretty exciting. Just got home. There's a nice little parcel from England, and I know what's in that. A few episodes ago, you would have seen me mucking around with these things, trying to get them on the truck. I managed to fit them, but unfortunately, they're for a Series 2, not a Series 1. Slight difference in the bend of them. You can see these ones come up and then kick in. The Series 1 don't do that. So I've set off to Warwick's to make a new set. Hang on. Mate, you're talking about measuring me stick. I need to get the video out. Put it on.
All right, your blank rod will have to measure to the center.
Yep.
So that we know to start here, and then we'll just put little gradual bends and use this as a template.
We can
get the curve.
We could measure this from here and get the length of it and just mark that off.
Yeah.
All right, I'll grab some pipe. So on the bender here, we've marked the center line, and then we're doing a bend every 200 mils out to the width. We found 660 is about where we've got to get the downward bend correct. We've also put a center line along the top so that we can keep it in an even plane that way. To have an extra pork chop for dinner tonight.
Yeah. Yes. You want to grab the square and we'll just have a quick walk. Take it out again and in and out and in and out. Yeah, it's got to go a bit more.
Yeah, I think so.
Must be right.
Yeah. So just bending up these pipes, what we've done is we've bent them to the shape of another Series 1 pipe. Warwick helped me with that, with his bender. There's a bit of grunting and groaning. Anyway, the lengths I had were a little bit short. So what I've done is I've welded the washer on there and extended with a thinner foot on there. I've still got to clean all that up. But they work quite well. I've got a few more to do, those ones. So with the vertical hoops finished, I've got to make the horizontal connectors. So I'm just going to cut those to length and then use the press to flatten the ends and bend them to shape before drilling the holes and fitting it all together. Fits rather nicely in there. Got the Exmoor trim storage bags up there. Canvas canopy over the top. Perfect little camping setup. Got the storage underneath, all the way up to the front there. Quite a nice little setup. You can have the rear hood down or roll it up the top like that for a bit of open air camping. Beautiful thing about this is you can hang a little mozzie net off there, keep the mozzies off you at night. So next week we'll be taking George on a bit of a trip, a bit of an adventure up the coast a bit. We're going to sort of back road it up to Mystery Bay and see how she runs, and also test out our camping setup. So come along for the ride. If you haven't hit subscribe, please do, and hit the bell next to it, which is a notification button. Thanks to those of you who have subscribed, we really do appreciate that. And don't forget to hit the like button, please. That really helps us out and gets our videos out. That's pretty much it for the week. I really hope you enjoyed that. I'm glad she's registered and on the road. Look after yourselves and look after each other, folks. We'll see you further down the road a bit. Ciao.